Rabotai, vous êtes mission of Hashem. I would like to wish you Be'ezat Hashem Shana Tova Betuka. You should have a good year Be'ezat Hashem. And I pray to Hashem to give you, to all of you, Beracha Ve'atzlacha. As you know, all of us, we prepare ourselves this year for the Sabbatic year, Sabbatical year for this year. This year is the Shemitah, as you know, in Eretz Israel, in Israel. During, the Torah said that during 6 years, you will work your land, but in the 7 years you are not allowed to touch your land, you're not allowed to grow, to make grow trees, or just put water to have herbs. You're not allowed to work your land. It's a mitzvah. That mitzvah, it's only in Eretz Israel. In Eretz Israel, Hashem, he wants us to know that Hashem, he is the one who provides food. He's the one who gives money. He's the one who gives you anything you need. So after Hashem, he wants you to believe on him, to have emunah, faith, hope, everything. You have to, like a Shabbat, during 6 days you work, and the 7 day Shabbat, you're not allowed to work. So Hashem said as well that during 6 years you will work your land, you will, but in the year of, I would like just to tell you exactly what the parasha said. And it's very, very, very important. It's a mitzvah because this year, it's the year of the Shemitah. So I would like just more the har. Voilà. So. Well, the Torah said, when you come to the land that I am giving you, the land should rest on Shabbat to God. You may sow your field for 6 years, and for 6 years you may prune your vineyard and gather its produce, but in the 7 year the land should have a complete rest, a Shabbat to God. You should not sow your field. You should not prune your vineyard. This is a mitzvah that during 6 years you can sow your field, but after the 7 year the land should have a complete rest. It's a mitzvah that we don't know why, but as I told you before. It's mitzvah, it's to show you and to teach you that you should not ask yourself what you're going to eat this evening after that year that you will not sow your land. What you will eat, Hashem will provide you. Hashem wants to give you a lesson of emunah. So this year we start on Rosh Hashanah, the Shemitah. The Sabbatic year start on Rosh Hashanah. So now we have a question. We have the question. Why it should start on Rosh Hashanah? Why? Why? Why the Shemitah start on Rosh Hashanah? First question. The Torah said Veshavta that the land should rest to God. Look the word. The word when you come to the land that I'm giving you, the land should rest a Shabbat to God. The land should have a complete rest a Shabbat to God. I mean, I understand that I am David Pinto. If I am tired, I rest. But why the Torah used the word that the land should rest? The Torah should say, hey you, when you come to the land that I give you, don't work your land. But the Torah said that the land we do a Shabbat. The land cannot understand. The land cannot talk the land. To ask the land, Veshavta Shabbat Lashem, that the land should do Shabbat. I am a man, I can do Shabbat. I can rest. But the land cannot rest. The land, it's me who will give her the opportunity to rest. But if you read the word of the Torah, you do not understand that the Torah are talking to me. The Torah only said, when you come to Israel, the Torah don't say, when you go to Israel, you don't work your land. You have to give the land to rest. No, the Torah said that the land should rest to God. I mean, it's me who will give the opportunity the land to rest. The land cannot rest without me. If I want to work in that 7 years, so the land cannot stop me. So why the Torah will not use the language that when I come to Eretz Israel, I should give the opportunity to the land to rest? It's me, because the Torah is talking to me. So the Torah should tell me, David, when you go to Eretz Israel, give the opportunity after you work 6 years, you can sow your field, and after 6 years, give the opportunity to the land to rest, give her the opportunity to rest. The Torah don't talk like that. So why the Torah said, "Beshavta Ari Shabbat Hashem"? The Torah should say, "Ki tavu el Ari Shani Uten Lachem, Lo Ta'avdun Et Ha'aretz Veshavta Ha'aretz." This is the question that we would like to understand. Why on Rosh Hashanah the Shemitah starts, and why this kind of mitzvah? And why this kind of mitzvah that Hashem give us, and why the Torah will not use that, I will give the opportunity to the land to rest. Why the Torah will not say that? So as you know, that on that year that you don't work your land, the Torah permits to anybody who wants to eat, he can go to your field and eat. You cannot stop him. During 6 years, you do business with your field, you do business with all the food that the field provides you, but the day, but on the year of the Shemitah, you're not allowed to stop people not to come to your field. For 6 years, you can stop people not to enter your fields. They're not allowed to eat, but and that year of the Shemitah, anyone can come to your field and eat and do whatever they want. Anyone, Jewish, not Jewish, people, poor people, rich people, they can you imagine that? It's incredible. Incredible. It's incredible. This is the Torah would teach you that at least you have to learn on that year how to be a good man. I mean, just imagine. You are a rich man. You have a lot of fields. You have thousands of trees. And that 7 years, the year of the Shemitah, people go to a field and they eat and they eat and they eat. And you will say to yourself, what how am I going to live? What's going to happen? What about? I mean, it's impossible. Just imagine. You know, Carrefour, or Casino, you know, those big supermarkets that they will let you once, 1 year, 1 year, each after each 6 years, for 1 year they let you enter and take whatever you want. I mean, you will do bankrupt, they will do bankrupt. It's impossible. It's impossible. But no. Hashem said, if you do that, you will have the bracha. Hashem will teach you If really you depend on Hashem, if really you believe that Hashem is the one who gives you everything you need, so believe and Baruch Hashem. This mitzvah, for thousands of years, the Jews do this mitzvah in Eretz Israel. And Baruch Hashem, all those who do this mitzvah, Hashem provide them all what they need. All what they need. Be'emet, I'm telling you. It's a big mitzvah, it's a hard mitzvah, but from this mitzvah you learn how to have bitachon, how to have faith in Hashem. That Hashem asked me to do tzedakah, Hashem asked me to do chesed, Hashem asked me to give 1 year for everybody to eat. Okay, I'll do it. How I'm going to live after? How I'm going to live? You will see. I will give you 3 times the blessing. 3 times the blessing. 3 times. Just try. I mean, look, if this mitzvah, up to now they do it, that means that there is an experience that all those who respect this mitzvah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu give them whatever they want. I tell you something. It's something incredible. You know, sometimes there is a lot of people ask me money. This institution, this, and Baruch Hashem, usually I don't say no. And sometimes I give more than what I get. Like now, I've been receiving people all day, and all what I receive, I give it to somebody for the Chagim, for the holidays. Everything, my match, everything. And then I give him more than what I've been receiving people. From 9:30 in the morning to 6 o'clock in the evening. So can you imagine? All the money I give it to him. And not only that, I put more money on the envelope to give him. And Hashem, he gave me 3 times the amount. When I give it to him, somebody came and he told me, can you give me your talit for the holidays? I said, yes, I can tell him no. He said, I want to give you this amount. I was shocked. 3 times the amount I give. So you see, if you want to do, compare yourself like Hashem, the same way Hashem gives you anything. These people who are rich, do they deserve to be rich? Maybe not. And Hashem give them. So Hashem, he give you. You don't deserve, and he give you. So give. Do chesed. Hashem, you want to teach us to do chesed. That for during 6 years, we work our fields, and after the year of the 7 year, from Rosh Hashanah, you stop, you don't work. Now let all the fruit, all the vegetable, all what you feel the field give it to everybody. Everybody should eat. Yes. It's incredible. As the Torah said, the produce which grow on its own during the Shabbat of the land will be on the less end will be to you to eat and equally with everybody else. You maid, you female slaves, Jews or not Jews, if you hire some workers that live with you, they can eat, they don't need to ask you permission to eat. And all its produce that the land gives you, maybe you can eat by your domestic animal. And give it to the white animal, anyone. The Torah said, you should count for yourself 7 sabbatical years. 7 years, 7 times. This is another mitzvah, the Yovel. It's a big mitzvah. After 7 sabbatical, after 49 years, you should announce, it's on Yom Kippur, we have to blow the shofar and announce, hey, it's a sabbatical year as well. And what do we do in that Yovel? If you bought in your houses, so after 49 years, you have to give back the house that you bought from somebody, give it him back. It's incredible. These 50 years will be a jubilee for you. Just like during the sabbatical year, you should not reap for yourself. It's incredible. It's the Torah asks us some mitzvot that are incredible to do. And Hashem, He wants to teach you that nothing belongs to you. Everything belongs to Hashem. You are in this world only for a lapse of time. That's it. You should only listen to Hashem. You came to this world to do Torah and mitzvot. So Hashem, He trained you that you are here only like a tourist. First, He asks you, work 6 days, Shabbat you rest. Have emunah on Hashem. That will provide you food and money for the week to come. The Shemitah, the sabbatic year as well. You work 6 years in your field, and the 7 years, you don't touch your field. Anyone can come and eat. Don't worry. And after 7 Shemitah, after 49 years, if you bought a house, give it back to the one who sold you the house. It's incredible. So there is no real estate. I mean, I buy a house to live in. I buy for investment, and then the year will come. I have to give back the house to the one who I bought the house. Look, it's hard. It's a hard pizza. But Hashem, He wants to teach us to do chesed. And Hashem wants to teach us that we are here only for a time of limit. Nothing, and when we die, we take nothing with us, we take only Torah and mitzvot. I know a lot of people that this year passed away. Billionaire, millionaire, rich people, poor people. I mean, we have to understand that here we are only for a lapse of time. So my friend, I would like now to tell you this. We have 2 questions. The first, why the Shemitah start on Rosh Hashanah? First. Second, we must know why Hashem said that the land should rest. I mean, the Torah should tell me, David, you are the owner of the land, you have to give the land to rest. But it's like Hashem is talking to the land to rest. He should talk to me. My friend, I saw some books that when we care about people. So from the Shamayim, they care about us. When somebody wants to get married, and we help him to get married, when somebody is in need, we help him. So from up there, they help us. Even with animals, if you say an animal that he's angry, you have to give him food to eat. A lot of tzaddikim, they give food to the animals. I mean, not because an animal, a lot of people they may say, well, let the animals provide for themselves food. No, if really you see an animal that really is in need, you have to help him. You know, the Gemara said that one day Rabbeinu HaKadosh, the one who wrote Mishnayot, he was in his Beit HaMidrash, and there was a cow that he came to the house because the Shohet wanted to, you know, to do the shechita to the cow. So Rabbeinu HaKadosh, he said to the cow, the go of the shohet, you came to this world to be eaten. And Bashamayim, And from up there, they were very upset. They said, look, it's not good that Rabbi Noah Kaddish talk like that. Okay, I know that the cow will come, he is here to be eaten. Okay, but it was not a way to be cruel. Even by talking, it's cruel. Yeah, you came here to be eaten. And go with the shohet. I mean, he pushed him, go with the shohet. I mean, it's not nice to talk like that. I mean, I know the cow is here for to be eaten, but even to a cow, there is a way how to talk to. He ran away because the cow, he saw the knife. He understand. He saw some cows that they've been did shechita to them. So he saw blood. So he ran away. So at least be nice to him. So you have to be not to be cool. You shout like a man, a person who is cruel with animals, he can be cruel to the people as well. So he was ill a lot of years, until one day, the maid of the house of Rabbi Noah Kadosh, they find some mice. You know, usually we're afraid of mice. And she was screaming, I catch them, I catch them. Rabbi Noah Kadosh, she said, oh, they're babies. I mean, usually a mouse in the house, babies. I mean, you just imagine yourself, you have a mouse in the house. You will not sleep nights. And Rabbi Noah Kaddosh, he felt so pity for them. He said, no, they're still babies. Let them with the mother, not throw them. Don't give them to the cat. Let them in the house. So Bashamid said, ah, now that you have Rachmanut, now that you show that you have a good heart, so you will not be ill anymore. So they send him refuah shelema. So you see, my friend, that even with animals, you have to have a good heart. Now you understand, if a man, he has rachmanos from to animals, of course he will have rachmanos from to a person. There was a big tzaddik, Rabbi Eliyahu Lopian. There is some pictures of him that used to give milk to the cat. It was a cat that she had the babies, and he used to feed her himself. There was somebody who took a picture. So now we understand, Hashem gave us the Shemitah. The Shemitah, there is a lot of sacrifice in the Shemitah. And we can imagine, I'm a millionaire, I'm rich, I have a lot of fields, and the 7 years I'm not allowed to do business with my produce, I have to give it away. Why? Because I have to show chesed, I have to do chesed, I have to be rachmanot. Can you imagine that I have to abandon everything for the poor people? When the Shemitah come and you abandon all your field, that nothing belongs to you, that means you prove to Hashem that nothing belongs to me. Everything is yours, Hashem. It was mine. Now it's not mine anymore. Now it belongs to everybody now for this year. And I do this mitzvah with happiness. And you have to do it with happiness. This is the tachlis. This is the reason why a man, person, come to this world. He came to this world to listen to the voice of Hashem, to serve Hashem. Now we understand why this mitzvah, we started on Rosh Hashanah. Because on Rosh Hashanah, it's Yom Adin, it's the day of the judgment. The day of the judgment. We don't know what's going to happen to us. So when Hashem said, you see, that we prepare ourselves to do Shemitah, we prepare ourselves to do Chesed, to be Rachmanut for 1 year, I will not give away, I will not. Nothing to myself. For 1 year, I will not do business with all my produce, and I will give them to the poor people. When Hashem said that's what I'm going to do on Rosh Hashanah. So on Rosh Hashanah, Hashem, he write you lechayim tovim shalom. I think this is extraordinary. This is the reason why the Shemitah starts on Rosh Hashanah, because on Rosh Hashanah it's Yom Hadin, it's the day of the judgment. When Hashem he see that already prepare yourself to start to do Shemitah on Rosh Hashanah, so already you're clean, you're clear. I mean, that's it, Hashem, he give you, for Hashem, you're a tzaddik. You are tzaddik. Yes. So, Bashamayim, yes, correct, exactly, no. Bashamayim, would you see that you prepare the year of the Shemitah to give it away to the poor people, to everybody? So, Meshamayim rahamim alecha. They take all the averot, all the sins that you did, they throw them away. Now, when there is no Shemitah, each year when there is no Shemitah, usually, the Gemara said we have to give a lot of tzedakah during the month of Elul till Kippur. We have to give tzedakah. What it is? Why there is why to do tzedakah? Because when the Bishamayim, they see you that you have Rachmanos, that you take care, you have good heart for people, so they have Rachmanot on you as well from the Shamayim. They feel sorry for you. They feel sorry to give you bad things from the Shamayim. So they postpone the bad things that you did during the year, they throw it away and they give you the Midah Kenegid Midah. You are Rahman, they are Rahman with you. That's it. You are Rahman. You have Rahmanus, so they have Rahmanus from you as well. And this is one of the mitzvah that Ma'ani Rahum Gamata Rahum. The same way that Hashem is misericordia, you should be Rahman as well. My friend, I would like just to tell you this. How much a man should care about himself? I mean, on Rosh Hashanah Kippur, we don't know what's going to happen. How many people we knew that they passed away? We don't know what's going to happen. So if you're one of us, he should do something, because we don't know what's going to happen. Look, Bemet, between you and me, we don't know what's going to happen. Who knows? Who knows? It's like, God forbid, you fly, you take the plane. Do you know what's going to happen? Nothing. We have confidence that everything will we will fly, we travel, everything will be good. But no, nobody knows. Look at that plane of Malaysia. Up to now, we don't know what happened to him. Disappear completely. We don't know what happened. I mean, no one knows. You leave your house. Do you know what's going to happen when you leave your house? You go to work. You take your car. You think how many people they took the car and God forbid something happened to them? How many people they took a bicycle and something? One of the rabbis I know, I prayed with him. After the tefillah, I took the bicycle. 5 minutes later, we heard he died in a crash. Nobody knows. So when you are Rahman, when there is, you have misericord, when you have a good heart to do good things with people, and really you want to be like Hashem, because Hashem is misericord, Hashem is Rahman, Hashem does everything with people. I mean, even with the Rishayim HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he maintained them. So if you want to compare yourself to do like what Hashem is doing, so they will do with you from the Shamayim the same thing. You act, they will act with you. Now you understand. For the Yovel, it's on Yom Kippur that they will blow the shofar. I was thinking, why Yom Kippur they blow the shofar for the Yovel? Because the Yovel is very, very hard. I mean, to give your land back to people for who you bought the land, it's very hard. So on Yom Kippur is the day of the Chatima. On Yom Kippur, there is a big difference between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. Rosh Hashanah is the day of the judgment. Yom Kippur is the day that if the judge was bad, it could be fixed on Yom Kippur to be good. So Kippur is it's a very, very holy day, Yom Kippur. That's why only on Yom Kippur we announce the Yovel with a shofar. Why we announce the Yovel with the shofar? The shofar to remind you Rosh Hashanah. To remind you that on Rosh Hashanah everybody is judged. He's judged by Hashem. And we do everything we can that Hashem can have Rachmanot on us. So Hashem, he said, okay, you wanted to have Rachmanot on you? So have Rachmanot from that one who had no choice just to sell you his land and give him back the land. What about you? I take care of you. You take care of him, I will take good care of you, and I will give you anything you need. So that's why we blow the shofar, because that's why the mitzvah of Yovel, we blow the shofar on Yom Kippur. Remind people because Yom Kippur is very, very important day, and because it's very important day, so it can it's give a big effect to the people that they will give back the land on the Yovel, on that year of the Yovel. It's as well the Shemitah that year and as well the Yovel. So you see, the Torah teaches you how you want that they will have Rachmanut on you from the Shammai, so have Rachmanut as well for you, the people that you know. On Yom Kippur, we blow the shofar to remind people to give back the land. It's the Yovel after 49 years. To remind the people, Yom Adin, the day of the judgment of Rosh Hashanah, that shofar, to remind us Rosh Hashanah, that on Rosh Hashanah, they act with you the same way you act with your friend. You are good to your friend, they will be good with you from the Shamayim. Mi shemerachim al acharim, umkayim mitzvot asher beratzon, merachamim alav. There was a big rabbi, Rav Chaim Kreuzberg, alav shalom, that he said that when he was a baby, when he was at 17 years, he was in the yeshiva, and he was there was a young man who came to the yeshiva, but he has no room and bed where he can sleep, and he was sometimes like a blind boy. So Rav Chaim Kreuzberg, alav shalom, he was the big chief rabbi of Antwerp. He gave him his bed till he find a place. For a few years there was no. He did not find the bed, and Rav Chaim Kreuzberg, he was giving a speech. He said, for a few years I was sleeping on the floor, and I had very, very bad back, because winter and summer I was on the floor. And he said, when the Nazi came, Mahashim, the Nazi came, they started to kill the Jews, and they started to kill all the students, one by one. So they called me, Chaim Kreuzberg. They call my name to shoot, to kill me, like they kill my friends. When I was walking, I said, Hashem, please, do me a favor. Do me a favor, Hashem. I'm not a better person, better than my friend. I'm normal. But Hashem, please, do me a favor. The same way I act with my friend, that I give him my bed and I sleep on the floor. Please, do me a favor. I was Rachman. No one gave him the bed. I was the only one who gave him the bed. For few years, I was sleeping on the floor. For that mitzvah that I did, please Hashem, save my life. And Rav Chaim Kreuzberg, he was giving a big show, and he told the assembly, when I arrive, and the Nazi took the gun to shoot me, he looked at me, and he said, I feel sorry for you to kill you, but now, I will count till 10. Run away. And he started to count. 1, 2, 3. So Abraham Kreuzberg, he said, he was shocked. He did not understand. Where he's going to run. He did not eat for a few days. He had no strength. But he started to run. And then after he finished the 10, he started to shoot. But Baruch Hashem, no bullet came. And he had his life saved. Abraham Kreuzberg, he said, I'm sure, if now I am an old man, and I'm alive, I'm living, and Baruch Hashem, I study Torah, and I become chief rabbi of Antwerp, only because of the chesed that I did with that man. That man that he came to Varsovie because he was blind. I'm sure only because of this chesed. From this story, you understand, when you do chesed, you have your life saved. So Hashem, he wants the Jews, he wants to train them not only to give small chesed, to give. He wanted to teach them to give, to do big chesed, like giving back the lands to the owners, like this, the Shemitah, the Sabbatic year, not all the produce that the land give you, you give it to everybody. Can you imagine? It's incredible. Hashem wants to teach you to be a big ba'al chesed, big ba'al tzedakah, because Hashem, he wants to teach you to depend on him, and if you do chesed, so they will do chesed with you, b'shamayim. Because a man who do chesed in the Shemitah, he will train himself to do chesed after the Shemitah. So all the time he will do chesed. A man who give back the land that he bought after 49 years. So of course, if he does that, I can imagine, he will all his life he will do chesed. It's incredible. Each one should know that what Hashem wants from us is that to hear, to listen, all the mitzvot that he, to accomplish all the mitzvot that he gave us. When Hashem created the world, Hashem, he saw the world and he created. He saw the Torah and he created the world. So that means that the world was created with the Torah. It's like, to make bread, you have to put water and the flour. Without water and the flour, you cannot do bread. So Hashem, when he, so that the world will maintain. So Hashem put Torah. Through the Torah, that the world is maintained. Without the Torah, so now the land, the field, they know that their duty is to serve Hashem. That's what the Torah said. V'shavta ha'aretz Shabbat l'Hashem. That Hashem, he said to the people, hey man, you know that the land, then she knows that the year of the Sabbath, the year that she should do Shabbat, she knows that she will not accept that you will work on her. She wants to do Shabbat. The land want to do Shabbat, you will not let her do Shabbat. V'shavta ha'aretz Shabbat. The land that cannot talk, the land that cannot hear, the land it's domem, the land it's something that has no, cannot move. She knows that her duty in this world is to do Shabbat on the 7th year. The land knows after 49 years, She must be back to the owner, the first owner. They know, and you don't know. That's why Hashem wanted to teach the man. If you don't respect the land, so the land is more intelligent than you. The land is better than you. Because the land, she knows her duty in this world, you don't know. And you don't know, you do not listen to what the Torah said. My friend, the body, the eyes, the nose, the mouth, the heart, the feet, the hand, they know they be created to serve Hashem. They know. I mean, I'm not a robot. They know. It's you who you don't let them serve Hashem. Your conscience, your tzara. They know that they were created to serve Hashem. And you don't let them serve Hashem. That's no good. You know, yesterday I heard two things. It was a couple that they came, they told me that, Rabbi David, thank you for praying for us. I was sterile. I could not have children. I went to all the doctors, all We made all kind of examines. My body was sterile. My body was, we could not have children. And you told us, respect Nida, respect Torah and Mitzvot. And Hashem, Be'ezrat Hashem, will give you children. We were laughing, Rabbi David, we were laughing at you. I mean, even the doctors, they were laughing. They said, you have nothing, you cannot have children. And Baruch Hashem, they have children. When she started to do Torah Mitzvot, Hashem gives them children. The doctors cannot understand. They don't understand. Why? Because there is, sometimes, because the body knows that when you serve Hashem, your body can change his nature. And yesterday as well, Bemet, how many times he said they heard miracles, people that they had cancer, that they were supposing to die, and Baruch Hashem, they started to put tefillin, they started to do Torah mitzvot, because the body, he wants to serve Hashem. And when you don't let him serve Hashem, so he become angry. So he don't listen to you. So he started to do other things. Please listen to this. Sometimes I see people eating taref. They eat a steak, the plain, with a big Magen David. And they drink wine. I feel sorry for them. And I know that the body is screaming. The mouth is screaming, please, don't let the taref come to my mouth. And the hand is screaming, please, I don't want to cut the steak. And the kish, the stomach is screaming, I don't want this taref in my body, please. And the eyes are screaming, I don't want to take, I don't want to enjoy by looking at this beautiful steak, please. It's not kosher. You force your body to eat what you should not eat. You force your body to touch what it should not touch. You force your body to see what it should not see. Aye, 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 aye. And the feet is screaming, is suffering when he goes to a place that he should not go. And the hand is not happy that he, unfortunately, he touch or he still thinks that he should not do. They see things that we're not allowed to do. That's what the Torah said. Veshavta haaretz. The body knows what he comes for. It's up to you to do the directions, to take the good decisions. Your body knows. Hanishama alach ve'aguf pa'olach. The Neshama came from Hashem. And the body, Hashem will create it. And Hashem will give you wisdom, chokhmah, intelligent, intellectual, to use your body for the good things. Like the land, Veshavta, the land, she knows what Hashem wants for her. It's up to you to give the opportunity to the land to respect what Hashem wants from her. The land herself, she's talking, she's asking to do Shabbat, to do Shabbat, to do Shemitah. So Rabotai, on Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, when we declare to do this year Shemitah, we declare to give back the land to the owners. So, min ha-shamayim, from heaven, from the Shem, from up there, they will be good to us. Mi shimgalei rahmanut, migalei rahmanut alav. Amin, Rabotai, on Rosh Hashanah, we declare, I'm nothing, I have nothing. I am battle. I'm nothing. My feeling is nothing belongs to me. When you feel that there is nothing to you, so Bashamayim as well, they feel that they will give you anything you need. Anything you need, they will give it to you. I wanted just to tell you here one thing that I would like just to finish with this. Be'ezat Hashem, with the zechut of Rabbi Chaim Pido, may Hashem give you Shana Tova, Bracha Ve'atzlacha, Bri'ut Ve'et Hashem. So don't forget, when you buy produce from Israel, make sure, because this year is the Shemitah, make sure that that what you buy is from last year, it's not from this year, or you have to, you might ask the rabbi what you can buy, what you are not allowed to buy, please. It's very, very important. So I wish you, to all of you, Shana Tova, and God bless you. My people, because your Kippur is very, very important day, and because it's a very important day, so it can, it's give a big effect to the people that they will give back the land on the Yovel, on that year of the Yovel. It's as well the Shemitah that year, and as well the Yovel. So you see, the Torah teaches you how you want. That they will have rachmanut on you from the Shammai, so have rachmanut as well for you, the people that you know. On Yom Kippur, we blow the shofar to remind people to give back the land. It's the Yovel after 49 years. To remind the people, Yom Adin, the day of the judgment of Rosh Hashanah, that shofar, to remind us Rosh Hashanah. That on Rosh Hashanah, they act with you the same way you act with your friend. You are good to your friend, they will be good with you from the Shamayim. Mi shimrachim al acharim, umkayim mitzvot al shiberatzon, merachamim alav. There was a big rabbi, Rav Chaim Kreuzberg, alav shalom, that he said that that when he was a baby, when he was at 17 years, he was in the yeshiva, and there was a young man who came to the yeshiva, but he has no room and bed where he can sleep, and he was sometimes like a blind boy. So Rabbi Chaim Kreuzberg, alav shalom, he was the big chief rabbi of Antwerp, and he gave him his bed till he find a place. For a few years, there was no. He did not find the bed, and Rabbi Chaim Kreuzberg, he was giving a speech. He said, for a few years I was sleeping on the floor, and I had very, very bad back, because winter and summer I was on the floor. And he said, when the Nazi came, Mahashem, the Nazi came, they started to kill the Jews, and they started to kill all the students, one by one. So they called me, Chaim Kreuzberg. They call my name to shoot, to kill me, like my friend, like they kill my friends. When I was walking, I said, Hashem, please, do me a favor. Do me a favor, Hashem. I'm not a better person, better than my friend. I'm normal. But Hashem, please, do me a favor. The same way I act with my friend, that I give him my bed and I sleep on the floor. Please, do me a favor. I was Rachman. No one gave him the bed. I was the only one who gave him the bed. For few years, I was sleeping on the floor. For that mitzvah that I did, please Hashem, save my life. And Rav Chaim Kreuzberg, he was giving a big show, and he told the assembly, when I arrive, and the Nazi took the gun to shoot me, he looked at me, and he said, I feel sorry for you to kill you, but now, I will count till 10. Run away. And he started to count. 1, 2, 3. So Abraham, he said, he was shocked. He did not understand where it's going to run. He did not eat for a few days. He had no strength. But he started to run. And then after he finished the 10, he started to shoot. But Baruch Hashem, no bullet came. And he had his life saved. Abraham Kesved, he said, I'm sure, if now I am an old man, and I'm living, and Baruch Hashem, I study Torah, and I become Chief Rabbi of Antwerp, only because of the chesed that I did with that man. That man that he came to Varsovie, because he was blind. I'm sure only because of this chesed. From this story, you understand, when you do chesed, you have your life saved. So Hashem, he wants the Jews, he wants to train them, not only to give small chesed, to give, he wanted to teach them to give, to do big chesed, like giving back the lands to the owners, like this, the Shemitah, the Sabbatic year, not all the produce that the land gives you, you give it to everybody. Can you imagine? It's incredible. Hashem wants to teach you to be a big Baal Hesed, big Baal Tzedakah. Because Hashem, he wants to teach you to depend on him. And if you do Hesed, so they will do Hesed with you, Bashamayim. Because a man who do Hesed in the Shemitah, he will train himself to do Hesed after the Shemitah. So all the time he will do Hesed. A man who give back the land that he bought after 49 years. So of course, if he does that, I can imagine, he will all his life he will do chesed. It's incredible. Each one should know that what Hashem wants from us is that to hear, to listen, all the mitzvot that he, to accomplish all the mitzvot that he gives us. When Hashem created the world, Hashem, he saw the world and he created. He saw the Torah and he created the world. So that means that the world was created with the Torah. It's like to make bread, you have to put water on the flowers. Without water and the flour, you cannot do bread. So Hashem, when he created, so that the world will maintain. So Hashem put Torah. Through the Torah that the world is maintained. Without the Torah. So now the land, the field, they know that their duty is to serve Hashem. That's what the Torah said. V'shavta ha'aretz shabbat l'Hashem. That Hashem said to the people, hey man, you know, that the land, then she knows that the year of the Sabbath, the year that she should do Shabbat, she knows that she will not accept that you will work on her. She wants to do Shabbat. The land wants to do Shabbat. You will not let her do Shabbat. V'shavta aretz Shabbat. The land that cannot talk, the land that cannot hear, the land, it's domem, the land, it's something that has no, cannot move. She knows that her duty in this world is to do Shabbat of the 7 year. The land knows after 49 years, she must be back to the owner, the first owner. They know, and you don't know. That's why Hashem wanted to teach the man. If you don't respect the land, so the land is more intelligent than you. The land is better than you. Because the land, she knows her duty in this world, you don't know. And you don't know, you do not listen to what the Torah said. My friend, the body, the eyes, the nose, the mouth, the heart, the feet, the hand, they know they be created to serve Hashem. They know. I mean, I'm not a robot. They knows. It's you who you don't let them serve Hashem. Your conscience, your tzara, denotes that they were created to serve Hashem, and you don't let them serve Hashem. That's no good. You know, yesterday I heard two things. It was a couple that they came. They told me that Rabbi David, thank you for praying for us. I was sterile. I could not have children. I went to other doctors. We made all kind of exams. My body was sterile. We could not have children. And you told us, respect Nida, respect Torah and Mitzvot. And Hashem, be'ezrat Hashem, will give you children. We were laughing, Rabbi David, we were laughing at you. I mean, even the doctors, they were laughing. They said, you have nothing, you cannot have children. And Baruch Hashem, they have children. When she started to do Torah Mitzvot, Hashem gives them children. The doctors cannot understand. They don't understand. Why? Because there is sometimes, because the body knows that when you serve Hashem, your body can change his nature. And yesterday as well, Bemet, how many times he said they heard miracles, people that they had cancer, that they were supposing to die, and Baruch Hashem, when they started to put tefillin, they started to do Torah Mitzvot, because the body, he wants to serve Hashem. And when you don't let him serve Hashem, so he become angry. So he don't listen to you. So he started to do other things. Please listen to this. Sometimes I see people eating taref. They eat a steak, the plain, with a big Magen David. And they drink wine. I feel sorry for them. And I know that the body is screaming. The mouth is screaming, please, don't let the taref come to my mouth. And the hand is screaming, please, I don't want to cut the steak. And the kishkish, the stomach is screaming, I don't want this taref in my body. Please. And the eyes are screaming, I don't want to take, I don't want to enjoy by looking at this beautiful steak, please. It's not kosher. You force your body to eat what you should not eat. You force your body to touch what you should not touch. You force your body to see what you should not see. Aye, 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 aye. And the feet is screaming. He's suffering when he goes to a place that he should not go. And the hand is not happy that he, unfortunately, he touched or he still thinks that he should not do. Everyone, they see things that we're not allowed to do. That's what the Torah said. Veshavta haaretz. The body knows what he came for. It's up to you to do the directions, to take the good decisions. Your body knows. Hanishama alach ve'aguf pa'olach. The Neshama came from Hashem. And the body, Hashem created. And Hashem will give you wisdom, chokhmah, intelligent, intellectual, to use your body for the good things. Like the land. Veshavta, the land, she knows what Hashem wants for her. It's up to you to give the opportunity to the land to respect what Hashem wants from her. The land herself, she's talking, she's asking to do Shabbat, to do Shabbat, to do Shemitah. So Rabotai, on Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, when we declare to do this year Shemitah, we declare to give back the land to the owners. So, min ha-shamayim, from heaven, from the Shem, from up there, it will be good to us. Mishim gali rahmanut, migali rahmanut alav. Amin Rabotai, on Rosh Hashanah, we declare, I'm nothing, I have nothing. I am battle, I'm nothing. My feeling is nothing, it belongs to me. When you feel that there is nothing to you, so Bashamayim as well, they feel that that they will give you anything you need, anything you need, they will give it to you. I wanted just to tell you here one thing that I would like just to finish with this. Be'ezat Hashem, with the zechut of Rabbi Chaim Pido, may Hashem give you Shana Tova, Bracha Ve'atzlacha, Bri'ut Ve'et Hashem. So don't forget, when you buy produce from Israel, make sure, because this year is the Shemitah, make sure that that what you buy is from last year, it's not from this year, or you might ask the rabbi what you can buy, what you are not allowed to buy, please. It's very, very important. So I wish you, to all of you, Shana Tova, and God bless you.